Good evening. If you are just joining us tonight, welcome to the Allen Performing Arts Center. This is the third performance of the evening at our December concert featuring our honored guest clinicians and composer. We will now have a performance by the Allen High School Wind Ensemble under the direction of Dr. Philip Ovato. For this performance, a portion of this is in preparation for the Midwest Clinic performance that Dr. Ovato will speak about briefly. But we have a number of guests involved in this performance. Joshua Blankenship, the Lowry Freshman Center Director of Bands, will be guest conducting. Also, we have Professor Joseph Luloff, guest soloist from Michigan State University. Dr. Giovanni Santos, guest composer from La Sierra University. And Dr. Kevin Sedetal, guest conductor from Michigan State University. They'll be performing a program with several pieces, Timba by Giovanni Santos, Beautiful River arranged by Carol Brendan Chambers, Concerto for Alto Saxophone Movement 3 by Stephen Bryant, Irish Tune from County Derry by Percy Granger, and A Deep Reverberation Fills with Stars by John Mackey. Please help me welcome to the stage Dr. Philip Ovato and the Allen High School Wind Ensemble. Thank you all for being here. This is a special concert for us, and we're so happy to share this with you. I know it's awkward to talk right at the very beginning, but I think it's important that we know a little bit about this first piece, and I want to introduce its composer, Timba. And if I could welcome Dr. Giovanni Santos to the stage to talk a little bit about this piece.
I've had the pleasure of working with this band this week, working on a piece that I was commissioned to write, Timba. Timba is really a work that pays homage to Cuba, where I'm from. And it goes through Timba. What it really means is that it's kind of a groove. Timba is a Cuban groove. And what I've done with the piece is that it goes through different Cuban grooves, starting with music that started with the African diaspora. And instead of talking for a long time about the history, I wanted to show some of the instruments the percussionists don't know this yet. Now they look scared. But I wanted to show some of the instruments that we're using in the percussion section that maybe you haven't seen before, or in fact, some of them haven't been used for band before. So if I can have, I'm gonna have you come up actually. So if you have the shekere. Yeah, the cowbell, the bottle. You know who you are. So you'll, just by looking at these instruments, you'll see, the long way from this. Section I really try to implement them throughout the piece. I'm having them come up because you can't really see them in the back, and I want to make sure that you see what they look like, what they sound like. So we'll start with an instrument that looks like a gardening tool, right? So if you think back, when the enslaved came to Cuba, they didn't have instruments to play, so they would find whatever they could to celebrate music. So this wasn't the case in a lot of places in America. They weren't allowed to play music unless you were in Congo Square. In Cuba, they were allowed to play music after they worked. And this is what the guataca sounds like. That's it. We'll never get that much applause for playing that ever again, so enjoy the moment. We all know the cowbell, we know where it came from. If you watch Saturday Night Live, you know what this is. Except as a band director myself, we usually say less cowbell. But this is what it sounds like. The following is just a glass. glass Coke bottle. Really, my favorite and probably the hardest to play, and I know you have to work on this, is the shekere. That's it. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoy the piece.
introduce two people to the stage. First of all, he's going to be the conductor of this piece. He's going to be Mr. Josh Blankenship. He's going to be conducting this piece in Chicago at Midwest. And before he comes out, I'd like to introduce the composer of Beautiful River, Mrs. Carol Britton Chambers.
And again, I just have to say, can we just give another round of applause for that amazing composition? So this next piece is going to be a completely different style and mood. It's a more of a lyrical piece that I wrote a few years ago, and it's called Beautiful River. And just to give you a little insight about the piece, it is actually based on a traditional Christian hymn, which you may know as Shall We Gather at the River? And so I just named it Beautiful River. It was written by an American pastor and gospel music composer, Robert Lowry. He wrote lots and lots of hymns. But here's the little story behind it. One hot afternoon in July 1864, as Pastor Lowry was resting on his sofa, visions of heaven pervaded his senses. He saw the bright golden throne room and a multitude of saints gathered around the beautiful, cool, crystal river of life. He was filled with a sense of great joy. He began to wonder why there seemed to be many hymns that referenced the river of death, but very few that mentioned the river of life. And as he mused about it, the words and music to this hymn then started to come to his mind. So that's a little bit of the inspiration. He really wanted to focus on the river of life. So I hope you enjoy Beautiful River. And this is Joshua Blankenship conducting.
there's a little bit of setup for this when we get going, but I do want to introduce our next guest artist. It's been a treat, and we're so grateful that a mentor and a friend, Professor Joe Luloff from Michigan State University, agreed to play with us at Midwest. And we're going to be playing the third movement from Stephen Bryant's Concerto for Alto Saxophone. Just real brief, I'm not sure how many people listen to bebop, fusion, jazz kind of stuff. There's a lot of influence in there, and it's a lot of fun. Some of you might be like, oh my gosh, this is cool. Or, what is happening? But I guarantee you, it's virtuosic, it's amazing, it's musical, and we're so lucky that we get to play with them. So please give a warm welcome to our guest alto saxophone soloist, Professor Joe Luloff. I'm tapping out. So, a dear friend, colleague, mentor, is going to be conducting our next piece. He's the director of bands at Michigan State University, and I was fortunate to be one of his students, always learning from him, even today. And it's always interesting the lessons that I have in front of my students, but always learning. That's the thing, being open, vulnerable, and what a special thing. He's also our liaison at Midwest, and we're so glad to have him back. He was here a couple years ago with one of our pre-UIL festivals a couple years ago, and he's going to be conducting Irish Tune from County Derry. Please give a round of applause to Dr. Kevin Sedgwick.
Thank you.
Thank you again for coming this evening. We're going to close our portion of the concert with a piece entitled Deep Reverberation, Fills with Stars by John Mackey. He came out and worked with us a few weeks ago on this, and while we're still moving, I can talk a little bit about the piece. He wrote this during the pandemic, and it's in the program notes, so I can say this. He was recently diagnosed with ADHD. And you know how to handle that medication, adult ADHD, plus there are other personal things that are going on, and just for a creative person to be creative in the least creative moment in history was really hard. So a deep reverberation was a darkness and how it fills with stars. So there's moments of darkness, there's moments of joy, there's moments of celebration, and I hope you enjoy John Mackey's A Deep Reverberation Fills with Stars.